Hello, my name is DeAndre,
and this is my friend Clay, and we are both students here at Mesquite ISD. We are both going to graduate soon, and we want to make sure you get on the right track.
High school goes by a lot faster than you think, and it's really important that you use each semester of high school to prepare for the next big step after graduation.
Taking the right courses so that you are ready to graduate in 4 years is really important. To do that, you have to know what's required and sign up for the right courses each spring.
Those decisions in the spring are what keep you on the right path for graduation, so that in 4 years, you've taken the required classes and you've passed all of your state assessments for graduation.
That's what this meeting is all about, making sure that you have all the information you need to make good decisions about course choices during the next few years. Our friend Bruna will help you give a quick review of the Texas High School graduation plan.
The MISD plan for graduation is a four-step plan. It's called the Foundation Plan with Endorsements. The Foundation Plan has 24 credits. Every student in MISD must take these 24 credits to graduate. There are some substitutions allowed in special situations, but for the most part, every student will take these courses. The second part of the graduation plan involves earning an endorsement, which is just a specific area of study. Every student must choose an endorsement to work on. The endorsement area can be changed, but it's very important to choose an endorsement and stay with it. It's essential that a counselor is involved anytime a change in an endorsement is made, just to be sure that the right classes are taken so that you can graduate on time. It's expected that everyone will have at least one endorsement at graduation. There are a few circumstances where an endorsement isn't required. However, a parent must meet with the counselor and give written permission before a student can be dropped from the endorsement plan. The endorsements are really the great part of the high school plan because they are full of fun and interesting courses. These are the five endorsement areas. I'll tell you a little bit about each one of them. Even though there's just five endorsements, there are many pathways to get to each of the endorsements. So you need to decide early which endorsement you are working on so that you can get started on the pathway courses you'll need to take. The STEM endorsement is all about taking courses in science, technology, engineering, and math. In this endorsement, you can choose to take classes in math or science that includes an advanced course like forensic science or engineering math. If you like math and science and you like using technology, you'll like this endorsement. Another endorsement is business and industry. All of these career clusters are a part of this endorsement, so you can take classes like architecture or interior design. You can take finance classes like accounting and business information management. Culinary arts is another cool class in this endorsement area, as well as travel and tourism management. Retail marketing, auto tech, and collision repair are some of the classes for the business and industry endorsement. Journalism is also a part of this endorsement for kids who like working on the yearbook or newspaper. Public service features careers such as education, health science, law, and public safety. If you want to be a teacher, you'll want to be in this endorsement area and take classes like Ready, Set, Teach. Or maybe JROTC is something you're interested in. Also, in this endorsement are the courses that have to do with health science, like clinical rotation and pharmacology. With the arts and humanities endorsement, you'll take classes in English, social studies, languages other than English, and fine arts. So, if you're in a fine arts class like band, choir, orchestra, art, or theater, you'll want to think about this endorsement. Arts and humanities is also for the person who really likes social studies. You can take four levels of the same language or two levels of two languages and get this endorsement. The last endorsement is called multidisciplinary because it's about taking advanced courses across all the core content areas. So advanced placement classes, dual credit classes, and advanced courses in other endorsement areas are needed for this endorsement. The multidisciplinary endorsement is very dependent on what you take your first 3 years of school that lead up to those advanced courses.
One important thing to notice is that all endorsements require Algebra 2 and English 4. These classes are essential for success no matter what path is chosen after high school.
In your graduation handout, you'll see more information about each of the endorsement areas. Pair that with course description guide that is on the district website to find out the kinds of classes that go on with each endorsement areas. A question that comes up a lot, Clay, is about getting more than one endorsement. Is it possible to get two endorsements?
Actually, it is, DeAndre. Some of the courses in one endorsement area are almost duplicated in another endorsement. So, depending on your course choice, you may get two endorsements.
But that's not something really to worry about. It's more important to choose an endorsement that you are really interested in and do well in rather than get two or even more.
And that brings me to another very important question. Just how do you choose an endorsement?
I'll answer that one, Clay. It is really pretty simple to choose an endorsement.
because the decision should be about taking classes that are interesting to you and prepares you for what you might want to do in the future.
For example, if I thought I might want to be a teacher in the future, I'd probably want to go to the public service endorsement and take classes like child development and Ready, Set, Teach.
Or, if you want to sing and be in the theater department in college, you might want to decide on the arts and humanities endorsements that fit perfectly with your choir and theater classes.
The course description guide tells you about all the classes that are in the endorsement pathway. Look for a pathway to an endorsement that interests you.
There's another part to the graduation plan, and that's the distinguished level of achievement. When you earn the distinguished level of achievement, it will appear on both your transcript and diploma. Also, you have to earn the distinguished level of achievement in order to be eligible for the top 10% admission to a state university. And it's really not difficult to earn the distinguished level. You just have to complete at least one endorsement and 4 math and science credits. You'll need the distinguished level of achievement to go to a 4-year university right after high school.
It's the goal of MISD for every student to reach the distinguished level of achievement. That's what every 9th grader should be aiming for. At least one endorsement and the distinguished level of achievement. And there's a cool little reward waiting for you at graduation. When you graduate with the distinguished level of achievement, you'll get to wear one of these medals at graduation, and you'll wear these cool cords that match your endorsement area.
There's still one more part of the graduation plan, and it's called the performance acknowledgments. These acknowledgments are given for an outstanding performance in several areas. For example, you can get an acknowledgement if you take 12 hours of dual credit, or for earning a high score on an AP test, or the PSAT or SAT. You could also get one by earning a certification in a class like cosmetology, EMT, pharmacology, and a few more.
This is a lot of stuff to know, but the good news is that there's information to read and people to talk to about the different plans. Counselors and administrators are available to help. You can request an individual meeting, or you can ask questions about the graduation plan on the district website.
Just go to the district website and to the students and parents section. Under the academics section, click on graduation plan. You can read all about the graduation plans, or you can even see this awesome video again. You can click on ask a graduation question, and someone will reply to your question. The questions will all be turned into a frequently asked questions document on the website, so check back from time to time and see if anyone has asked a question that will help you understand all the ins and outs of the MISD graduation plan with endorsements.
I hope we've helped you understand the new graduation plan. Remember that the plan may have some changes, so you'll want to listen to your counselor and watch the district website for changes.
In the meantime, study hard, stay on track, and work on achieving the distinguished level of achievement as part of your graduation plan. If you have questions or need any help, ask your counselors. That's their job, to help you graduate on time with the courses you need for life after high school.